The Posh Club is a glitzy, friendly and spectacular daytime cabaret and afternoon tea club for people over 60. Mark Walker spoke to Becca Lunberg to find out more.
I just don't want to sit and play bingo. I come out here and I just feel smashing.
I think it's really quite magical.
It's been amazing. It keeps me going for the whole week.
So I'm joined here today by Becca Lunberg, who is from the Posh Club, and it's a new initiative in Brighton for the over 60s. Can you tell us a bit more about it, Becca?
Yes, so the Posh Club is a cabaret and afternoon tea club for people over 60. We've just been funded in Brighton for 3 years, and we're running at the King Alfred Ballroom every Thursday in April, June, August, October, December, February, continuing over 3 years. So it's an initiative for people over 60 to kind of meet new people, socialise, have fun.
Dress up,
watch live performances. So what our guests receive for the £5 entry fee is a full afternoon tea, so cakes and sandwiches, tea and coffee, a glass of bubbly, a raffle, and get to watch 3 live cabaret performances every week. And they're different every week. It's quite a big variety of things we have. So we have Elvis impersonators, opera singers, dancers, hula hoopers, comedians. It's a whole range of things that people get to see when they come along to the Posh Club.
So what's not to like there?
Yeah, exactly.
And you're based at the King Alfred, aren't you?
Yeah, so the King Alfred Ballroom, which is the only existing ballroom left in the whole area. So it's really nice to kind of see it being used for dancing and, you know, big events again. It's a fantastic venue. We love being there.
And what's the inspiration behind this? Because I know you weren't first established in Brighton, were you? And there's a really unique story behind it.
Yeah, so the first Posh Club was set up in Crawley about 6 years ago, and it was set up by brothers and sisters Simon and Annie. Their mum moved from London to Crawley to be with closer to Annie as she got older, but she didn't really know anyone. She was used to having quite an active social life. So Annie invited some neighbours along to her front room and did afternoon tea on vintage crockery. And her brother Simon, who has been running cabaret nights in London for kind of 25 years, thought, this is a really good idea. We could do something and, you know, lots of people would enjoy this. So the Posh Club was kind of founded by that idea.
Yeah, because in principle, really, it's obvious that people like to get dressed up.
Yeah.
You know, lots of people kind of want an excuse to get dressed up, so it makes perfect sense, really. But it's about putting that idea into practice, and your membership's expanding quite rapidly now, isn't it?
Yeah, so it started in Crawley, and then we did pilot runs in Brighton and Hastings last year, and we've been lucky enough in both areas to get funding for 3 years. We're also in East London, in Hackney, and South London, Elephant and Castle. So we've got, from just Crawley, we've expanded over the last few years into all 5 of those places.
Yeah. So how can people get more involved and join up?
So you have to book so that we know how many people are coming. And we've got information on our website, which is theposhclub.co.uk. We're also on Facebook, which is at the Posh Club One on Facebook. My email address is becca@theposhclub.co.uk, and my phone number is 07848 827 806. So any of those ways, people can get in touch to book themselves on.
And lastly, I know you've got a YouTube video which has got over 12 million hits apparently. So.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, one of our videos has been viewed all over the world by 12.4 million people, which is fantastic. And everyone who sees it loves it.
So the long-term ambition is to expand this beyond the UK then, potentially?
Possibly. You know, our dream would be to have Posh Clubs in every town in the UK and, you know, all across the world. But obviously, you know, it's kind of limited to funding and it can be quite difficult to establish a club in a place. There's lots of work that's put in behind the scenes. But yes, you know, we love the Posh Club. We see the good that it does and how kind of happy it makes people and how people change over the time that they come to the Posh Club. So, yes, we'd love them to be everywhere.
And also, there's a lot of initiative now ensuring that people interact with each other, particularly the older generations, and that they're not lonely, because loneliness is a big factor in this, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. And I would say at each of our events every week, over half of the people come on their own. You know, it's a really friendly event. And what happens is people meet people and make friends and then decide to sit together. And they bump into people that they haven't seen since they went to school, or people they used to work with, or old neighbours. So, you know, even if people come on their own, they do make friends and do meet people. And, you know, the way we set up the tables is designed so that it's kind of, you know, it's friendly and people don't feel isolated there.
Becca, thanks for coming in today.
Thank you very much.
All the best with the initiative.
Right, thank you very much. Okay.